Sit upon the lofty hill and turn your eyes around, where waving woods and waters wild do hymn an autumn sound. The summer sun is faint on them, the summer flowers depart. Sit still as all transformed to stone, except your musing heart. How there you sat in summertime may yet be in your mind, and how you heard the greenwood sing beneath the freshening wind. Though the same wind now blows around, you would its blast recall, for every breath that stirs the trees doth cause a leaf to fall. Oh, like that wind is all the mirth that flesh and dust impart. We cannot bear its visitings when change is on the heart. Gay words and jests may make us smile when sorrow is asleep, but other things must make us smile when sorrow bids us weep. The dearest hands that clasp our hands, their presence may be o'er. The dearest voice that meets our ear, that tone may come no more. Youth fades, and then the joys of youth, which once refreshed our mind, shall come as on those sighing woods, the chilling autumn wind. Hear not the wind, view not the woods, look out o'er vale and hill. In spring the sky encircled them, the sky is round them still. Come autumn's scathe, come winter's cold, come change and human fate, whatever prospect heaven doth bound can ne'er be desolate.
Thank you. Who will gather with me the fallen year, this drift of forgotten, forsaken leaves? Ah, who give ear to the sigh October heaves at summer's passing by? Who will come walk with me on this Persian carpet of purple and gold the weary autumn weaves, and be as sad as I? Gather the wealth of the fallen rose, and watch how the memoried south wind blows old dreams and old faces upon the air, and all things fair.
Thank you. hushed October morning mild. Thy leaves have ripened to the fall. Tomorrow's wind, if it be wild, should waste them all. The crows above the forest wall, tomorrow they may form and go. O hushed October morning mild, begin the hours of this day slow. Make the day seem to us less brief. Hearts not averse to being beguiled, beguile us in the way you know. Release one leaf at break of day, at noon release another leaf, one from our trees, one far away. Retard the sun with gentle mist, enchant the land with amethyst. Slow, slow, for the grape's sake, if they were all, whose leaves already are burnt with frost, whose clustered fruit must else be lost. For the grape's sake, along the wall.
October is the treasurer of the year, and all the months pay bounty to her store. The fields and orchards still their tribute bear, and fill her brimming coffers more and more. But she, with youthful lavishness, spends all her wealth in gaudy dress, and decks herself in garments bold of scarlet, purple, red, and gold. She heedeth not how swift the hours fly, but smiles and sings her happy life along. She only sees above a shining sky. She only hears the breeze's voice in song. Her garments trail the woodland through, and gather pearls of early dew that sparkle till the roguish sun creeps up and steals them, every one. But what cares she that jewels should be lost, when all of nature's bounteous wealth is hers? Though princely fortunes may have been their cost, not one regret her calm demeanor stirs. Whole-hearted, happy, careless, free, she lives her life out joyously, nor cares when frost stalks o'er her way and turns her auburn locks to gray.
Sweet are the woodland notes that gush melodious at morn from palpitating throats, in anthems fresh as dew. Aye, they are sweet. But from that dim retreat, where evening muses through the pensive hours, there sometimes floats along a more appealing song. So, love, thy voice breathes a diviner music in the chill of autumn, when the glen is still, and Flora's gold all tarnished on the hill, than in the time when merry May calls forth her bashful flowers.
Mm-hmm. My sorrow, when she's here with me, thinks these dark days of autumn rain are beautiful as days can be. She loves the bare, the withered tree. She walks the sodden pasture lane. Her pleasure will not let me stay. She talks, and I am fain to list. She's glad the birds are gone away. She's glad her simple worsted gray is silver now with clinging mist. The desolate, deserted trees, the faded earth, the heavy sky, the beauties she so truly sees. She thinks I have no eye for these, and vexes me for reason why. Not yesterday I learned to know the love of bare November days, before the coming of the snow. But it were vain to tell her so, and they are better for her praise.